Welcome back. You're once again with the EtherCode Innovation Team, the people who make technology accessible and turn possibilities into reality. In this video, I'll walk you through the step-by-step process of creating a honeypot token on the Solana network, and I'll show you how to list it on the most popular decentralized exchange, Radium. First, we need to install the software we'll be using later. Go to the website nodejs.org and download the installer. During installation, just leave everything as default. After it's installed, make sure to restart your computer. Now we need to download Visual Studio Code, which we'll use to work with the Honeypot script. This is where we'll set up the buyer freeze logic. Head over to the Visual Studio Code website and install the development environment. Again, just leave everything as default during installation. We'll be using Phantom, the most popular wallet for the Solana network. To download it, go to the phantom.app, choose your browser, and install the wallet extension. Now go ahead and create a new wallet. Make sure to save your secret recovery phrase. You'll also need to reserve at least 0.5 sol in the wallet. This will be used to pay the fees for creating the token, as well as for adding liquidity on Radium. To continue working with the script, we'll need to create a Solana RPC endpoint in advance. For that, go to the helios.dev. Click on Start for free, sign up using your Google account, and select the free plan. Once you're logged in, go to Endpoints in the menu on the left. Copy the generated RPC URL and save it. We'll use it later when setting up the script. We'll be creating the token using CoinFactory, which allows us to do it automatically. To get started, go to coinfactory.app, connect your wallet to the website, then click Create Token and select Create Token on Solana. Now come up with the full name of your token. In my case, it'll be Meme Bitcoin. For the token symbol, I'll use MBTC. Enter the total supply, for example, 1 million tokens. Upload a logo for your token. This can be any image you like. You can also add a description and enter some relevant tags. As for the additional settings, you don't have to enable anything. But under no circumstances should you revoke the freeze authority. This is critical if we want to use our script later to freeze buyers. Once everything's set, click Create Token and confirm the pop-up transaction in your wallet. After the token is successfully created, you'll see a summary of your token information. You'll also see the token address, and we'll need this later when setting up the script. You can also view your token on solscan.io. Just paste the copy token address into the search bar on Solscan, and you'll see all the details about your token right there. Radium is the most popular decentralized exchange for trading tokens on the Solana network. To get your token listed there, you'll need to add liquidity. To do that, go to radium.io and connect your wallet to the website. Next, go to the liquidity section and click Create. Select Standard AMM. This is the simplest way to add liquidity. Now set up your token pair. Leave the base token as Solana. This is the currency people will use to buy your token. Then click on Quo Token and paste it in the address of your token. Enter the name and symbol of your token exactly as you did when creating it. Next, decide how much liquidity you want to add. Enter the amount of Solana you'll use to provide the initial liquidity for your token. The more Solana you provide, the more solid and attractive your token will appear to potential buyers. Buyers will be able to view the full trade history and see that the token's price isn't easily manipulated, because it launched with strong liquidity. Now, enter the amount of your own tokens that you want to add to the liquidity pool. Click Initialize Liquidity Pool and confirm the pop-up transaction in your wallet. Keep in mind that Radium charges a 0.2 SOL fee for adding liquidity. Once the liquidity pool is successfully created, you'll see the address of the liquidity pool. Your token is now available for buying and selling on Radium. For example, you can go to dextools.io, paste your token's address into the search bar, and view the entire trading history and other useful details about your token. Now we need to prepare the script that will allow us to freeze buyers. To start, go to your desktop and create a new folder with any name, for example, script freeze. Next, launch Visual Studio Code, which we installed earlier. Click File in the top menu bar, then click Open Folder and select the folder you just created on your desktop. Now click New File and name the file freeze.js. Then hit Enter. Click New File again and name it config.json. One more time click New File and name it package.json. Next click New Folder, name it Data and press Enter. Right-click the Data folder and select New File. Name this file tech-config.json, then press Enter. Your folder structure should now look something like this. After that, go to our website using the link in the video description, where you'll find a page with four code snippets. Each snippet will be clearly labeled with the name of the file it belongs to. All you need to do is copy each piece of code and paste it into the corresponding file in Visual Studio Code. Once you've added all the code, save everything by click File, and then save all. Now we need to install the project dependencies. To do that, click View and open the terminal. In the terminal, type the command npm i and press Enter. If everything installs correctly, you should see a message like this one. However, it's common to get an error at this step during the installation. To fix it, you'll need to open PowerShell as administrator. Then you need to type the command set execution policy remote signed. After that, type A and press Enter. Once that's done, the previous error should be resolved, and you'll be able to install all the dependencies in Visual Studio Code by simply typing npm i in the terminal again. Now there's just one final step before we can launch the Honeypot script and start freezing buyers. Open Visual Studio Code and go to the config.json file. Here we need to replace all placeholder values with real data. In the private key field, paste our Solana private key. To get it, open your Phantom wallet. Copy your private key, then paste it into the private key line in the field. In the RPC endpoint field, you need to paste the RPC URL you previously generated on Helios. Just go back to helios.dev, copy the RPC URL you created earlier, and paste it here. In the mint address field, paste the address of the token you created earlier. Once all fields are filled in, don't forget to save your changes. Go to File and then click Save. The rest of the fields can be left as they are. However, for example, the whitelist field can be used to enter wallet addresses that should not be frozen. Wallets added here will still be able to sell the token even after the script is running. Next, setting freeze threshold, 0. This means buyers will be frozen even if they buy just one token. Freeze delay, 0. This means the script will freeze buyers immediately without waiting. Timeout, 180. This means the script will automatically stop freezing wallets after 3 hours. You can extend the script's runtime by simply increasing this value. It's important to know that all buyers frozen during the script's operation are permanently frozen. They will never be able to sell the tokens they bought. Before launching the Honeypot script, let's first test buying and selling the token from a new wallet. Go to Radium and try to buy and then sell your token. As you can see, we were able to buy and sell the token successfully. Now, to activate Honeypot mode, open Visual Studio Code, then open the terminal. In the terminal, type the command node freeze.js and press Enter. After that, you'll see a welcome message and various details in the terminal. From this moment on, while the script is running, any new buyers will be automatically frozen. Also, existing token holders will no longer be able to sell your token. You can stop the script at any time. Just click on the terminal and press Ctrl plus C on your keyboard. Now let's test buying and selling the token again, this time from a new Phantom wallet. As you can see, we were able to buy the token, but selling it is no longer possible. Keep in mind, the wallet you use to create and launch the token is automatically whitelisted and won't be frozen. Here is the wallet that was just frozen. All frozen wallets will be displayed in the terminal until the script stops running. You can run the script as many times as you want. There is no limit. After successfully launching your Honeypot token, you can withdraw all the liquidity. To do that, go to Radium, then open the Portfolio section, scroll down to My Positions, and click on Standard. Here you'll see the liquidity pool you created earlier. Click the minus button, select how much liquidity you want to withdraw, anywhere from 0 to 100%. Click Remove Liquidity and confirm the transaction in Phantom. As you can see, all the liquidity you added earlier, along with the buyer's money, will now be added to your wallet, along with any remaining tokens from the liquidity pool. If you have any questions, feel free to message us on Telegram at @OurCodeInnovation. We're planning to launch a separate project soon, and who knows, maybe we'll get a chance to work together if we manage to spark each other's interest. Also, if you'd like to order a custom script on the Solana network with specific functionality, just write to us on Telegram. We can develop anything you need, tailored exactly to your technical requirements.